I have an intellectual disability, which is a hidden disability. One thing I wish people could understand more about me is that I can't pick up things straight away like everyone else can. It takes me a bit of time to do things. I struggle with my reading, my writing, and I also struggle with people when they use jargon words, either written down or them talking about it. I am a self-advocate for Rainbow Rights, people with intellectual disabilities. It's a group run and for people by people with intellectual disabilities in the LGBTIQ community. We meet fortnightly to think of ways of how to bring our message into the greater community. The main purpose of Rainbow Rights is that it is for people and run by people with intellectual disability. So we all have an equal stand in the group, and there's no people in charge of the other people. You know, everyone in the group is all got an intellectual disability.
About 6 years ago, I acquired a spinal cord injury, so I'm paraplegic and I use a manual wheelchair to get around. I think I'd like non-disabled people to understand that people with disability make up about 20% of the population. So we exist, we're out there, we deserve to be included and represented. And dismantling ableism is everybody's responsibility. So in the last 6 years, I guess the barriers I've most commonly come across are physical barriers, because I am a wheelchair user. Things like steps, kind of annoying, can't get up them. But there's also like quite a prevalent negative perception out there about disability and people with disability, that we can't do things, we're often pitied, and not given the same opportunities. So the message that I'd probably want people to pick up from this, and I think I'm biased because I work in this space, is that we deserve to be represented and included, because it has such real power over the perceptions of us. So just represent us and include us.
I live with a very rare genetic skin condition called epidermolysis bullosa. My skin is my major disability affecting my entire life. It's the equivalent to living with third-degree burns every single day. It's one of the most painful and debilitating skin conditions the medical world has ever seen. However, that doesn't define me. I choose to live my life to its fullest and achieve more than I ever dreamed possible on a day-to-day basis. I wish more people in the community and in the world took the time to get to know people rather than just looking at their appearance and judging them or assuming that I was in a major accident or I was in a fire or I've got something major wrong with me. Try to get to know the person, whether they're disabled or able-bodied. I think everybody is these days judged a lot more than they ever should be, just based solely on their appearance or the way they present themselves. Everybody can contribute in a really positive and meaningful way. So I've been really lucky to be involved in disability employment, which is another passion of mine, to show that everybody deserves to work in the community and earn money and live the life the same as everybody else.
I have an intellectual disability, which is on the autism spectrum. I run my own YouTube channel called Planet Jassy, which is a kids autism therapy channel. We do different segments like craft or cooking, just simply playing games. It's a variety of different stuff. What I wish people would understand about me and my disability is that for me is to take me more seriously. Like, we are very capable of doing things. It might take us slowly to do things, but we do get there. And yeah, it's just about giving us more time to do things. But once we get it, we know what we're doing. I don't come across as the typical person with autism. A lot of people think that I'm normal, but I'm not. I have my own problems as well. To have more inclusion and have more representation of people with disabilities on the screen and in the media. That is a dream that I have, because we are very capable of doing things. It might take us much more longer to do things, but with the right people supporting us, we do get there. It just takes us a bit more longer.
I'm currently a student. As a visual artist, I'm doing a diploma and I'm a fourth year student. I particularly love printmaking and lino cuts. I am deaf and I have Usher's syndrome type 1. That means that I see a really tiny space in front of me, like a tunnel, and all around that tunnel is black. So during the day, I have tunnel vision and I can only see pinpricks when I'm getting around, but at night time I don't have any vision at all. From my experience, I've developed a dream that people in the community can become more aware about people who are deafblind. Please don't see us as people who are limited and who face many barriers. You know, I've been successful enough to complete the Kokoda Trail and the Trek, and many people over the years have always told me that I can't complete things, I can't do this, I can't do that. But you know what, I'm really determined to overcome all those barriers that I face, and I really don't like people saying, no, that's not possible. Deafblind people can achieve whatever they want.
My disability is a few different types of dysautonomia. So I have postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome, neurocardiogenic syncope, and orthostatic hypertension. Basically, all the stuff that your body does without you thinking about it, like heart rate, blood pressure, digestion, temperature, doesn't really work that well for me. I use a wheelchair just in case I get dizzy or faint or get too tired, just a whole bunch of different things. And a misconception about disability that I wish people didn't have was that everyone who uses a wheelchair is paralyzed or has a spinal cord injury, which is so not true. There are so many reasons why people would use a wheelchair. I always get so many weird looks whenever I like shuffle my legs around or get someone to help me to stand up to stretch out all my joints. And it's just really awkward, and I wish people didn't think that. I think something that could help change those misconceptions is just better representation in the media of disability and of people who use wheelchairs. Just better representation of like all the different things that might put someone in a wheelchair or require someone to use a wheelchair. And show people that like there are lots of different disabilities out there, and you just don't know people's stories.